2 years ago. I absolutely loved it. I'm kicking myself because I didn't buy one of those Russian costumes.
Oh, okay, you can get one here. That's not a problem.
Yeah, that one of those furry hats.
Yeah.
Oh, excellent. Come on in real tight. So tell me, how's it been for you over the Christmas season?
Yeah, it's been good.
Bit busy?
Yeah.
Did you get to enjoy Christmas lunch yesterday and everything?
Well, I was cooking, so it was too busy for me.
Well, Jin and I have interrupted your schedule today just make a little contribution to both of you. Do you like magic?
Yes, I love it.
Oh, excellent. Well, I'll tell you what, give these a good shuffle. I always like to begin with a shuffle deck in use. All right, we're going to try a couple of experiments just to get ourselves warmed up.
Okay.
Do you see the way he's shuffling right now?
Yeah.
This is the authentic Russian shoveling system.
Don't you shuffle it, how it's called in Russian.
But you've got to admit, they are well and truly mixed right now, right? All right, excellent. We're going to try something. Whenever you're satisfied, you can leave them down on the table.
Okay.
All right.
And one last time.
Excellent. Look at this. Really slick man. Now, right now, are you aware of the position of any card?
No, I don't think so.
Okay, watch this. I'm going to show you the condition of the cards after your shuffle. And as I go through, I want you to notice I am not altering the position of any cards. You can see the condition. See, you've got a couple of twos there,
yep.
Right? Can you see that?
Yes.
This is interesting, actually. And look at those two kings relatively close to each other. Now, check this out. One of my mentors told me a long time ago, when a deck of cards has been shuffled by the average card player, they actually believe that the cards are being mixed together. Now, every shuffle constitutes a stack. And what that means is, if you know the start position of one or two cards, you can reposition the best cards so that when you deal the cards out, you get the best winning hand. Do you play cards?
No, I don't.
How about you? Well, guess what? It's done. So if I deal out 1, 2, 3, 4, here's the fifth card, the Ace of Spades. Now imagine in a game like Pontoon or 21, this could be very useful. Of course, the hottest game in town right now is what's known as Texas Hold'em. Imagine if you had pocket aces in the hole. This is a good opening gambit, isn't it? Now back in the 1970s, seven card stud was the big game, and you always start with three cards face down. Imagine if you had trip aces to begin with. But of course, this is a theatrical demonstration, and I want to give myself all four aces just to round things up quite nicely. Eh? Fancy a game of poker?
No.
Would you believe what you've just seen is nothing more than a warm-up exercise for me?
Really?
Yeah, look at this. So now we can get into the magic now, okay? Look at this. Two aces. Two red, two black, all right? Got the heart, the diamond, and there's the club and the spade, okay? Now look, I'll leave the black ones top and bottom, red ones in the middle. If I turn them over, do you remember which black one's on top? But you were paying attention though, right?
Yeah.
Look, we've got the ace of spades, okay?
Yep.
Look, I'll leave that down on the table. Now, watch the other black ace. This is where I try and psych you out, okay? Watch this. Do you remember which one's on top?
Ace of spades.
Interesting. Do you know when I snap my fingers, they change places? When I cast a little spell, they change back. But you know what happens when I snap a third time? They really do change places. Now, I know you were paying attention there, okay? Or did you miss that?
I thought you put those down.
They kind of swapped under your watchful gaze.
Shall
I do that again?
Please.
Yeah.
Look at this. Watch the red aces. Oh, by the way, did you notice that the red aces are lighter than the black aces? Watch this. Did you see that? So if I drop them, light as a feather, my jokes aren't that great. Watch this. If I leave them on top, can you see that?
Yep.
Now I'm just going to reverse the order of the cards. If we wait a few seconds, they come to the top again.
Mm-hmm.
Look, I'll put them under the black ones. And once again, right back to the top. Actually, let me leave the ace of hearts down the table. Watch the ace of diamonds. That goes underneath. Once again, back on top. Do you know what? If I leave them on the table and take the two black ones, look at that, they turn red, you see. Get all four aces. Is this possible?
No.
Tell me something. What's your role working here at the Ibis?
I'm doing reception work. So I'm greeting people, welcoming people to the hotel.
So you welcome the people as they come in?
Yeah.
Do you realize you are the face of the hotel?
Yes.
You set the context for their experience here.
Yeah.
I wonder how you manage when you're not having a good day. Do you still have to smile?
Of course.
Yes.
Like no matter what, yes. So I ask this question because as a magician, my job is to induce the most amazing emotional experience for people. Astonishment. So can I try that with you right now?
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to ask you to give these a shuffle. Now you can do this one or you can scramble them on the table. I don't mind. Whatever's easy for you. Okay, this is the over and under technique, right?
I cannot shuffle that.
I'm going to have you join up to my academy, okay? Is this your cup or that's mine, isn't
that's
it?
That's yours, yeah.
All right, watch this. Once you've done that, give the cards a cut. Okay, take some off the top, place them underneath. Splendid. Let's move that out of the way. All right, good. Now, actually, I'll tell you what. Leave the cards on top of the glass, all right? Splendid. Now, you've seen magicians do tricks of one kind or another where they say pick a card, any card. This one's different. You've just shuffled the cards, correct?
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to show them to you one at a time. As they go by, think of one.
Mm-hmm.
Don't say it out loud, but you'll see one that you like, okay? Mm-hmm. I'm not going to look, all right? Head turn, okay? Have you got one?
Mm-hmm.
I could go for the whole pack, but it would be all day. Are you happy?
Mm-hmm.
Going to shuffle the cards for me? Splendid. Okay. Right now, would it be fair to say you're thinking of one card out of a small bunch? But when these cards are returned to the pack, they are. Pop those on top. Once these are returned, it's now one card out of 52.
Mm-hmm.
Don't you agree? Yes? Interesting. If I could read your mind right now and tell you exactly what card you're thinking of, what do you think? That'd be pretty something, wouldn't
yeah.
it? I've got news for you. I can't do it.
Okay.
I'm not that good. But you know something? There is a technique I have been practicing. It's called contact mind reading. Many years ago, there was a famous magician by the name of David Burglass. He would come to people's homes and ask them to hide an item of jewelry, something really valuable, somewhere in the house. He would be blindfolded, and they would hold him by the wrist, and they would literally, unconsciously, guide him to the exact location. I thought this is a really interesting experiment to play with, so I tell you what, I'm going to have you do something very similar with me right now. So hold on to my wrist, don't look at me, look at the cards, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Don't say a word, I'll show them to you. Tell me something, do I need to continue?
Mm-hmm.
I do?
Mm-hmm.
Yes? Okay. I want to make sure you get to see all the cards. I'll slow down so I don't go too fast. Do I need to continue?
No.
I don't need to.
You went past.
Sorry?
It went past.
Oh, let's leave it right there. Okay. That's interesting because I felt a slight tremor.
Oh, really?
Yes, I did. And do you know what's interesting? Look, if I shove these cards in right now, I think it'd be fair to say you don't even know where your card is.
No.
Can you hold these for me? Close your eyes for a moment. Can you see a mental picture of your card in your mind's eye?
Mm-hmm.
That tells me that your thought, the card you thought of initially, created a strong impression on you.
Mm-hmm.
Open your eyes. Look at me. I think I can do this. Look at this. I don't need to talk. Do you know what? My instincts tell me to stop right here. Tell me honestly, what card did you think of?
Six paths.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh.
That's impressive.
That was awesome.
I'm in the awesome business.
Yeah, that was cool.
That was impressive.
Oh my goodness. So my friends, I want to thank you so much for joining us.